What's happening, ladies and germs? This is the PackerMan, and welcome back to Green and Gold Games and my Let's Play of The Legend of Zelda Maelstrom, where in the previous episode we hit a bit of a snag. In the previous episode I could not find the recorder everywhere, so I checked a map online to see if I'd found all of the secret locations I had. I also tried out the power bracelet. Turns out those had caves that you could go to because the warp zones had been randomized. But they just led to regular items. So I basically came to the conclusion that the recorder was behind an unlockable place, because the level 7 dungeon was being protected by a dig dogger who was guarding the Triforce, and the level 8 dig dogger was protecting a door with no other ways to go. So I basically came to the conclusion that that run was completely unbeatable, which really, really sucks. So I've created a new version of Maelstrom. I've also added a few things to make things a little harder on myself as well. Some of the options that you could tinker with is add more boss characters, which I did. And another thing I did was also add more rooms where you had to either pay a heart piece or rupees to get past, you know, just to make things a little bit harder. But there's also one other change that I made, which you'll see in a minute. I start with the recorder this time around. Now you might be wondering, why wouldn't I give you an unfair advantage? No. For a couple reasons. Number one, there are three uses of the recorder, two of which are completely, almost utterly useless. One of those uses is that in the first quest, it really only has one use of this, by the way. I think it has like four in the second quest, but here in the first quest, it's used to open Dungeon 7 at the pond. And that's pretty much it for that usage. The second one is that it teleports you around the map to beaten dungeons, which again is kind of worthless. Now you can set an option in the randomizer menu for it to warp you to unbeaten dungeons, but then what's the point of the randomizer? You know, the randomizer is to discover the shit, not warp right to the dungeon entrances. So I've added the recorder, and of course the third usage is to make Dig Donger vulnerable to attacks. Now, the recorder doesn't actually deal damage to Dig Donger. It just makes it so that it'll make him vulnerable. Because in his normal form, he's big and slow, but he's also untouchable. But with the recorder, it'll make him slower, or fast, smaller, more maneuverable, but it'll also make him vulnerable to damage. And that's really the only real usage you get out of the recorder. So there's that. But with that out of the way, let's get this thing started. Good luck, we're all counting on you. I like how he offers a the candle as well, but we need the sword. I actually had a different version of this. It actually started me in a random location, and it completely randomized where the wood sword was, which does not do me any good whatsoever. Alright. Let's give this a shot. Okay, so those guys are completely randomized. Why not? Alright, let's check and see what's in the next cave this time. Old man. Well, that does me no good, because I need the letter. Alright, so what I'm going to do this time P-hats and levers. Well, I actually took down one of the P-hats. Tight. shit tons of damage. Moblins. Actually, the blue ones look like they still only get one shot to kill. More Lynels. Shit. It's already dangerous. Maybe this way instead. More Lynels. And more Lynels. Jesus. Relentless. Tectites. Boulders? Really? Hearts, please. Nope. Shit. More Lynels. Well, there's level 5. Which is this spot right here. I'll have to remember that. Alright, Great Fairy. At least you're still there. Damn it. Crazy one, but ow. At least that guy gave me a heart. Yes, I am going to be using Space Time Rewind, so deal with it. Listen here. Eat, sleep, Ganon, repeat. Cool story, bro. Let's go north and see what it's got. This cave. Ooh, level 1. Starting from the right side. So I found level 1 at least, which is beatable. Give me 1 second though. There's one thing I want to check. Damn it. What's here? Whoa. That is a lot of freaking. You know what? Let's go ahead and do level 1 right now. Fuck it. Didn't expect to find level 1 so soon. And we're starting with a key. Right off the bat. Of course, as per the usual, I gotta kill all these guys. Awesome sauce! I will gladly take the heart container. Whoa! Okay, I was not expecting a frickin' Petra. Okay, maybe level one isn't that safe. I was not expecting fucking Petra of all creatures. Of course, I did make it harder. Damn. That takes out a full 1.5 hearts. Well, shit. Looks like we'll have to come back. As hard as it is for me to say that, considering this is just the first goddamn dungeon. But, you know. Oh, thank you. Alright. Candy gram for Link. I will gladly take another heart container. Well, that brings us up to 5. In the previous run, where the armors are, there was a red ring. Obviously, I was hoping that it would be here again, but you know, it is what it is. Alright. Which means that once I find the white sword, I can grab it. So, that's cool beans. Alright, might as well get this out of the way. Cool. Show this to my brother. The letter. Love it. So that means that I can now gain access to something that I did not have access to in the previous run. The medicine. Kind of hold that thought. There's something I want to check. Oh, look at that triple kill. Whoa, Lionels. Alright. This was level 3. Now it is level 6. Okay then. Okay, so I found level 1. I believe level 5 as well, and level 6. Eat, sleep, again, and repeat. I would love to have that big shield, but I gotta make some money first. What's this cave? The warp. Okay. Eyes are up here, buddy. Okay. That's where that goes. Okay, and that's where that goes. Weird. Weird sauce. Okay, so obviously this is not going to be level one. Don't spin it all in one place. Cool beans. Now that I got bombs, I can go blow shit up. Blue ones are vulnerable. Going across the desert. Seeing some moblins along the way. I also added in a feature where select is no longer pausing the game. It can, as you can see in the beast section, I can switch between the different items without having to go without hitting the start button. What's in here? Hi, Billy Mays here. Nothing I'm really interested in at the moment. More Lionels and frickin' lemurs, Jesus. Meet the merchant along the coast. Well. What is up here? Eat, sleep, gain, and repeat. Another merchant. Okay. Alright, well, there's two spots over here that I can take a look at. The dude abides. Alright, so that's where the magical sword is. Yeah, there we go. And this is... Ooh. Don't ask me what I want the paper for. Damn, do I want that right away? Ah, fuck it. I'm not going to use it right away, because that would be a waste. Eat, sleep, gain, and repeat. Could use that candle. And there's that one. More bombs. This is... Medicine Man. Okay, it's not that one. Ooh, the magical boomerang. I'll take the magical boomerang. Alright, so let's go this way. and head up to where level 5 used to be. Waterfall is level 4. That, okay. Okay, so that's where level 4 is. What is here? Thank God. Ow. Alright, what's in this cave? No loitering. Fuck you, bastard. There's that. Which is actually not a bad idea at this point. I end up all the way over here. It's not exactly a bad thing, because there's stuff to look for over here. For instance, whoa. That's a lot of blue linos. And I am not taking that hit. Fuck your noise. Damn that slowdown. What's in here? Well, there's the blue ring. That I cannot afford at the moment. Alright then. At least I know where the blue ring is. Whoa, shit. Shoot your eye out. Yeah, you know what's coming. It's a bit unsporting, maybe. I don't feel like wasting time grinding just to get fucking rupees. Whoa. These random ass amounts. Alright. Let's go get that blue ray. If I can get over it. I'm supposed to kind of I'm a noob. That lag is so bad. Improved. Still not gonna do jack shit against these Lionels, though. Would be nice to know where the frickin' white sword is. That would be very lovely. Was this a bomb or war, or was one of these guys hiding something? intro. Same thing. Actually, you know what? This area. What is inside Pinnacle Rock? Some monies. I'll take it. There's one more spot over here. Was there a secret one right here? No. Okay. This was level 9 in the previous one. Pre-order version 4.0 now, just $19.99 down. Makes no fucking sense. Dodongo dwells with the red candle. Okay. No. Maria grumbles with the white sword. Leoc returns with the bow. Okay. This a bomb of them? Yep, okay. What's in here? Money making game. I don't think there were anything there. I do know there's one there. There's a blue vinyl that I take down. Alright, what's in here? No loitering. Fuck you. I'm fairly certain that there was a bombable here. Maybe I was wrong. I can't even get to the frickin' stairs. These goddamn pee hats. Awesome. Okay, I do know there was one right here, somewhere. us. Ooh, one right here, perhaps. There we go. Back at level one. Since I now have the blue ring, let's see what we can do to get past this area. We'll pick that up next episode. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again next time. Till then, take it easy.
Well, that is all for today's video. Thank you very much for watching. Be sure to rate, comment, favorite, like, and subscribe to my channels here on YouTube.com and over on BitChute.com. If you would like to sponsor my channel, go to my channel page at Subscribestar.com. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, this is the PackerMan, signing out. Have a good one.